Hello, everybody, and welcome back to RuneScape 3 From Scratch episode God who knows what, but something pretty cool is about to happen. I'm here with my buddy, whose name is slightly questionable, but I'm going to trade him real quick and give him this grimy fell stock, and let's see what he can do with it. Here we go. Yeah, boy. Yeah, boy, let's see you do it. Here we go, and oh, there it is. He has achieved 99 herb lore, which is absolutely sick. And then our plan that we came up with, which is a pretty nifty idea. Well, it was mostly him that came up with it. He's going to trade me back the clean fell stock, and now when I get 99 herb lore, I need to use this to make a potion to get 99. So we'll do that in, I don't know, whenever we get 99 herb lore. Congrats, man. I've been a little bit busy doing some crystal fishing, preftinus fishing, waterfall fishing. I don't know what it's called. This interface is really bad because I haven't worked on it at all. I just kind of made it full screen because you guys are really triggered by the small interface, so I might try to incorporate some kind of full screen interface so you can see more of the game. But we've got quite a few of these little urchins, and we have reached 96 fishing, almost 97 fishing actually. So I'm going to turn these into the shop here, and do I have to use them on her to trade them in? Or maybe I just have to have them in my inventory. And yep, okay, just having them in your inventory is enough for this. So let's see the unlocks. We're gonna take the crystal rod unlock, you know, sure, why not, and we'll take the master fisher title. And really, I don't know what to do with the rest of my points because I mean, I don't have the hermit crab pet, so there's really no point in me grabbing any of these things. I could redeem all of these for fishing experience, which is what I think I'm gonna do. I mean, look at these XP drops. It is so satisfying. I'm sure some people are like, oh my god, you idiot. What if you get the pet while you're fishing some more and you won't be able to buy his hermit crab boot? Well, then I guess I'll just do more Prithinus waterfall fishing. But yeah, we're pretty close to 97. Fishing might actually be my next 99, which is kind of crazy to think. But yeah, there we go. Pretty much done with this right now. Alright, here's our first Araxi kill of the task. I cut it a little close, but I forgot my Excalibur, so let's search the body. 700k. I think that's the best Araxi loot I've gotten so far. Let's go do another one. Alright, so I've been doing that Rax task. We've gotten like 3 kills so far, and everyone told me to get 5 faceted components to try to get enhanced devoted on my equipment, and I've heard this is really good, so we're gonna try to get it. I managed to get 5 faceted components, took me over 500 crystal flasks, spent a bunch of money. Please enhance devoted 3. What does crystal shield 3 do? 10% chance activate. Well, it doesn't matter. Let's go. Alright, so we just finished killing Raxor, and we got a Crystal Triskelion Fragment 3, which completes our, you know, Crystal Triskelion Key, which I thought we had finished before, but apparently we only had 2 pieces. So, now we're gonna go back to the bank, combine it, go open the chest, and get a Gemstone, Dragonstone armor piece or something like that, yeah. Alright, here we are at the Crystal Triskelion Rock Face. Let's open it. YOLO, no waiting, let's see what we get. 40k, baby. 40k, baby, let's go. Let's go. Pretty sure this is one of the actual garbage ones you can get. Let me price check this. Let's see. Oh yeah, that's not very good for the thing, but you know, Luck of the Dwarves shines more brightly. Wait, what the fuck do you mean it shines more brightly? I thought you always got an elite clue. Maybe not. Okay, 250k. Alright, everyone's telling me if I'm going to keep doing a Raxor, I need to get the Venom Blood perk, and I guess this is like the most efficient way to get it at my level, so I'm going to close my eyes, I'm going to click, I'm just going to assume it's Venom Blood. It is! Let's go. Cannot auto-retaliate while this item is equipped. That kind of sucks, I don't know, maybe. Insert something about me getting a die, and some joke about me wanting to die, and there we go. Woo! That is... Alright, so I just got Raxi here to help me with all my effigies. I figure I'm just wasting, you know, kills basically by not using up my effigies, because like the more effigies you have, the lower chance of getting an effigy. You can only have 5 effigies, so I'm just going to throw them all into agility. 30k XP, so that totals up to be just about 150,000, well, it's a little bit over 150,000 agility XP. Not too bad. Hey, we actually got an agility level. There is 86 agility. And it was totally worth it. Alright, so here we are back at the giant oyster. Y'all know I don't get anything good from this, so I'm not even gonna get excited about it. Actually, that's the best oyster I've gotten honestly, so I'm not gonna complain. But now that I have 96 fishing, I want to see exactly how much experience I get from this fishing spot. Now let's see. Come on, 7,000 experience times 20. That's like 140k free XP, and that's gonna get me to 97 fishing, actually. Should I even bother recording it? Alright, time to use our monthly reset on the Tutorial Island Oyster. Yes, I'm sure. And here we go. Let's go! Okay, it's worse than last time. That sucks. Alright, so I just killed Araxi again. This time was on 100% enrage. I think if I go here, it should say, yeah, current enrage 100%, and after I loot this, it'll be at 120. Which is really nice. The more you kill it during the day, I think the more its enrage goes up. But let's search its body. 248k. See, that's so bad, and I really want to just do pet chance because it's more fun that way, but we're just gonna bank it. And there is a 120% Araxi kill. Now we just need one more to finish this damn task, and I don't want to wait till tomorrow because I've already got a Reaper task rolled over, and so I guess we're going for a 140% enrage kill. Let's search the loot. Well, there we go. There's the, I think that was 140%. Yeah, 140% enrage. There's the Reaper task done. Didn't even have to use the sign of life, thankfully, but yeah, I think I'm starting to get a Raxor down. It's going to be a lot easier once I get better armor. Although these perks really did help, especially that defensive one. I think it is helping out a lot. But let's search our last loot. 450k, not too bad. We got 35 Reaper points from that because it was our 40th assignment, so let's go get a new one. So I came back to the Prithinus waterfall because I just can't help myself. It's like an addiction to fishing. We're pretty close to 98, but I just wanted to finish up these two fishing rod-o-matics because I had to edit a video and stuff. And boom, look what we got. We got the hermit crab. I didn't even see the message in the chat. It was just kind of there, and I saw it in the inventory. So I'm a little disappointed. I don't think this pet goes into the pets interface unless it's like the follower. No, I don't think it does, which is a bit unfortunate, so I have to just keep it in the bank and it takes up a bank space. But here we can walk with the hermit crab and it follows you around. It's pretty cute, I guess. Yeah. Okay, some of you guys said you wanted to see every hard clue, so don't worry, you got Luck of the Dwarves equipped, which is gonna give us super good luck. I guarantee it. I don't know if I'd call that super good luck. Let's go for the reroll. You've gotta be kidding me. It's the two unique rewards and no fortunate components. That's nice. Whoops, I almost missed it, but I was killing some cows here in Lumbridge. And, oh, that's cool. We just reached 2300 total level, which is pretty nifty, actually. 2300 total is pretty much a nice milestone. I think next we'll go for 2400 total, because I think it looks nice. I heard this lady sells a pretty cool cape. Let's see. Can I buy this cape from you? 99,000 coins. Sure, why not? Now, I made a mistake with the range cape. Someone told me that you can actually just click the hood and combine it onto the cape, so I could wear the cape with the little hood on the back. And I mean, I don't know which one I like better. Although the Constitution cape, I mean, also, wow, I just realized how overpowered this is. It boosted my life points by like 19. Oh my god. No, it's been a little while since I've done my daily challenges. Whoops, I probably should be doing them every day, but I've taken care of three of them. Two of them, like the Runespan one and the Magic Shortbow one, they're just going to take too long, so I'm going to wait until I am AFKing the game a bit. But let's turn in the other three challenges. We got Nemi Forest Blessing. Yeah, that's pretty decent. 12,000 prayer experience for basically no work. Next up, we've got Decorated Cooking Urns. Pain in the ass, but good crafting experience. And then the Prif Agility Course. 20,000, that's actually pretty decent. I'm kind of hoping for that one in the future, because it's not that I hate the Agility Course, and you can AFK it. It's just, eh. It's just eh. So let's see if we can get anything good. Oh, yeah, it's the bonus chest, so we're, you know, it's going to be decent no matter what. Let's see, yeah, large XP lamp mining, that's pretty awesome. Emerald necklace, let's see what we get three of. Yeah, three small divination XP lamps. That's a little disappointing. Alright, there we go. I decided it's been just way too long since I've decided to do this quest line, so there's Missing Presumed Death complete. We've got quite a few rewards here. Some, yeah, I really don't know what I'm going to throw these into. I might as well throw it into defense, since that's what I'm trying to... Actually, I think it's kind of a waste to throw it into defense, but it's a little too late. I already put it in there. Let's throw that in agility. There, that into prayer. And I think if we open the invitation box and go back to the Citadel, there are some extra rewards that we can claim. It says talk to the statue again. Oh, it's out here. Oh, thank goodness. Okay, so this statue here, and it should give us some extra rewards. We're not going to be able to get the thieving lamp because we are 72 thieving. You actually need 75 thieving to get this reward, so give me my rewards. Do I have to claim the one by one? Oh my god. Alright, I got the lamp. So the antique lamp can be used on any skill over 75, I think. I'm going to throw it on agility, of course, because, you know, screw agility. And then we get 50,000 constitution experience. Very helpful. And that's pretty much it. We got 30 barrels amulets. I don't even know if these are worth using, but yeah, there we go. And with that, I think I'm going to end the episode off here. There's so much stuff I really want to do right now. Like, just completing Missing Presumed Death makes me want to just go straight down that storyline. So definitely one of the first things I'm going to be doing in the next part is doing the Fate of the Gods quest. And then we're also going to go back to Broken Home to get that Asylum Surgeon ring. It's been way too long since I've done that quest. I should have gotten that a long time ago, but I was like, yeah, it's going to be forever before I get 85 defense. And lo and behold, it actually did not take forever. Why are the skills so out of order? It's really strange. Let me just, there we go, put it like that. So here are our current stats right here, guys. We got 2,300 total. This level feels good. We also got a Slayer assignment. That's pretty good. You know, I can't find the Slayer bar because I haven't made this inner. Oh, here it is. Black Dragons. So I'm also going to do that entire task at the QBD and see exactly how much money we can make. But yeah, next episode is going to be good. Lots of QBD, lots of questing. Hopefully work ourselves towards Ritual of the Majorette as well, as that's a quest you guys have been telling me I really need to get done. And we also really need to do the Light Within, or is it called Within the Light? Yeah, it's called the Light Within, I'm pretty sure, because we need those Siren spells for skilling. Anyways, thanks for watching the video, guys. If you enjoyed, please leave a like rating down below and subscribe to see some more videos in the future. Also, our current playtime is 39 days, 18 hours, and 39 minutes, which I can't believe we played this game so much this year. But anyways, I'll see you guys next time. Goodbye.